Let that prana through the sense of smell enter your heart. Let it vibrate there. Let it throb. Let it quiver. No matter how many times you smell the rose, it never fails to overwhelm you. Feel the bliss of it. Don't hold yourself. It seems that we know it all. Yet when the veil of reality been torn, everything is anew. Anew, anew. Constantly, all the time. You want to experience reality? Through partaking in creative juices of this universe, then you better be stunned by the utter wonder, unpredictability, and newness of it all. This is when you no longer perceive the world as like, I've seen it already.
So I was singing at Sand, and I was walking across a foyer, and Igor was sitting there with about 8 or 9 people. And I walked by, and my body just turned. And then I met the eye of a woman, and she smiled. She said, come. And I did, and I sat down, and he was talking about the exact same thing that I faced for the last 4 years that I didn't know what it was. And I started crying, and I'm not a crier. So I drove back the next day to the talk, and I cried all the way through, and my body started just twitching like that. And I thought, I need to go to that man's retreat. So I did.
The way that Igor teaches may begin on a verbal level, seemingly, but then he actually transmits the experience of it.
I've never seen so many changes, so much transformation in such a short amount of time with so many people.
I always wanted to rest on my last awakening laurel or the place I'd reached in my own understanding of true nature. And for me, the teaching is go further. I've gone further, come with me.
My experience prior was non-duality and spaciousness, and there was a lack of reverence. And it was this weekend that I realized that's what's been missing.
How to integrate the intensity of bliss with our daily business, our daily duties. This is literally where you are able to test every bit of realization that you've gained here. So in other words, I'm not inviting you to contract, but I'm inviting you to create healthy boundaries which are necessary to protect that sprouted new consciousness that at this stage is still tender.
His integrity is absolute, and his teaching comes from a place of experience. It doesn't come from theory. And I think that's incredibly unique.
I really can't hide. He'll point out exactly that one piece of me that I'm not seeing or I'm afraid to look at, or that one little tidbit of something special, and it's not his words. It's in his words, but it's this energy that he transmits.
I think Igor recognized the piece in me that needed to be seen in our first meeting. And it became obvious in the retreat, he has the ability to do that with each member, to see what needs to be just tweaked. You know, sometimes they're big tweaks, sometimes they're little tweaks, but he has that tweakability down.
There's a real bonding in the community held by Igor that really helps. And of course, on a one-to-one, Igor can always, he'll always sort you out, put you. Help you to see it from your higher self.
Perhaps a third of the group have witnessed their actual awakening, which has been profound and beautiful to witness.
There's not a dependency here. It's like, here is who you are. And then when you leave with that gift, it's magical, because it does continue to work with you. It's as if you take home a gift of grace and it's all bundled up, and then it has this growth on its own with you in your life, in your home, in your work, with your children, and it just spills out, and it's quite magical.
If I share with you the bliss and grace and to invoke and to instrument in any way, then it will be selfish of me not to relate to you. The most immediate and the most profound realization is that life becomes easier when we learn to trust that everything is achieved without moving a pinky. When you think how just a gentle touch of that intent moves everything. And you become that movement yourself. You are that intent. That takes us to the core of the teaching. Will, knowledge, and action are the very primordial womb of Shakti. Universe herself comes out of there. Millions, billions of universes. And it is that primal source of energy where everything else comes out, in your own being. The most powerful force of creative intelligence is born out of the will, knowledge, and action. There's no experience outside of the field of Satchitananda. You see, this is where you bring the sweetness of that heart realization with sharpness of understanding, of sharpness of comprehension. The senses themselves are the sources of continuous reunion going on. It's not mood making. It's not becoming a bliss junkie. You cannot become a bliss junkie. You already are.
I feel like I'm in the hands of a very wise mother. And even though he's a man, my experience is he's a very wise mother. It sort of feels that way to me.
He seems to have like a library in his head of all these, of all this ancient knowledge. And so that's one level, and then there's another level which is energetic. And Igor, to me, can be speaking about a film or whatever, and still that Shakti is flowing.
Loosen up a bit. Why are you taking life so seriously? Why are we taking life so damn seriously? When we do that, we're in danger of actually letting life pass us by. And we don't want to do that. Sadhana, spiritual sadhana, the most serious spiritual practice has that side. That's why you're all cracking up so much when you rest after meditation. You get the joke.
A lot of people see spirituality as just sitting down and feeling all blissful and that. Whereas what's going on here is like real work. There's no joke about it. Even though everyone's laughing, like it's serious work. Like there's really your change is happening. You can tell, like, after someone's been crying or laughing a lot, you look in their eyes, you can see there's like something's changed. There's like a light is coming through, their eyes are shining more. And I think that's a real sign that something's going on, that something's happening.
Two people that I know from the beginning of this retreat that look like they lost 20 years. I mean, literally, they look 20 years younger. Just in the last few days. And I feel for myself that a huge burden has just been lifted for me in this retreat.
Just as you are striving for that union with the beloved, that union with the divine, union with your own self, there is union already taking place each time your hand touches something. Behold that union now, your skin, every orifice of your body, every cell of your body is for the purpose of that union, and it is present at every level of existence. This union with the disunion.
When I'm with Igor, I've noticed that his ability to literally transmit grace is profound. And for me, that means that I'm accelerating at a new rate.
And I'm amazed to see, you know, some people that appear to be fairly new to the spiritual world that just even in this retreat have surpassed my 30 or 40 years of treading this path. I'm just amazed. I'm amazed.
I learned not to be afraid of what was arising in my experience. And I've been afraid for a long time, and I'm not anymore.
So let us close our eyes now. Straighten your spine, yet release any tension in the shoulders, drop your shoulders, and for a moment, simply observe the incoming and the outgoing flow of breath. Sense that repose.